Hello and welcome. This video is an introduction to workflow in Easy Redmine. This is the task detail page where we are going to focus on three key attributes: assignee, task type, and status. We start with the task type. Task types can be configured in administration. Go to More, Administration, Task Types. Here you can see the list of all task types, such as task, help desk ticket, feature development, and so on. To access more settings, click on the task type name. Task types can be assigned to projects. For example, when you do not need this task type, in help desk projects, you can remove it. Now, let's move to the statuses. You can see that most of the statuses do not have the parameter task closed set. This means that when a task has one of these statuses, it is still open. When a task has the done or canceled status, it is considered closed. Assignee is a user included in the project as a team member. Here, you can see a list of the project members and their roles. John has the developer role. Let's go back to the task detail. The task type is feature development, and the status is new. Now we move to the administration, workflow, and check how all this is interconnected. Here you can define the behavior and permissions for each role and each task type. Choose role and task type. Click the edit button to modify the workflow settings. When the status is new, user can move it to realization to start working and consult the task. This way you can define the workflow for any role and any task type, meaning we can set which roles can close the task and which roles cannot. Let's go through the settings in more detail. The role developer cannot change the task status to the new. This means that when a user receives the task, he must start working on it. Also, he cannot put the task into the done or canceled statuses, so the user cannot close it. However, there are other possibilities. You can define that when the user is the author or assignee of the task, he can have additional permissions. For example, he can close the task. It means that the author of the task with this workflow has additional permissions. We have saved the settings, and now let's have a look at it from the worker's perspective. When user updates the task, he sees only the task statuses allowed for user's role. However, the status transitions are just one part of the workflow. Let's look at the task detail again. Here you can see other fields, such as start date, due date, author, estimated time, and so on. These attributes can also be managed by workflow settings according to the role and task type. Here you can see the standard fields visible on the task type and the custom fields. You can choose whether the field is read-only or required. For example, if you want your users to always enter a due date, set it to required, and do not forget that this setting applies to the new task status only. Do not forget to save the settings. This is how it looks like from the user's perspective. You are logged in as John, and when trying to update the task, you see that the due date is marked as required, and therefore is red. Okay, that's it. If you like to, you can learn more about workflow in Knowledge Base on our website. Thank you for watching, and good luck with your projects.